Why would I speak to you every day, unless it is from my desire to serve you, and serve you well? I do not waste my time or yours. There is some budging that is called for. There is some budging that is yours to allow. Move out of your way. No more blocking yourself from expansion. Although stillness is a great part of life, in terms of growth, you have to budge. You cannot stay the same and budge at the same time. Here is another way to say this. In your history, it is time now to budge. As you budge, you move on. My message to you today is, sail on. I say, sail on a dozen times a day, if you would but hear. To you, it feels so brave for you to sail on. It may feel to you that, as you sail on, you are losing yourself. You are right. Yes, it is time for you to lose yourself, for you are making room for your higher self to come to the fore. What are you letting go of? It is boundaries that you let go of. Let go of your sequestered bound little self and steer toward the greatness of yourself. This may feel like a taking away when, as a matter of fact, this is a great gift, for now you will rise up from the ashes of yesteryear. The way you rise up from a pool and dry off in the sun, rise up from your circumscribed past. You disperse yourself into the sun of yourself. As it has been said, you lose yourself in order to find yourself. You are finding yourself, which is to say that you are losing your hold on past thinking and rising to new vision as you let go of the old. You get out of yourself and come closer and closer to me and further away from self-centeredness. In the world, it is as if you started on a course in life, and now you are ready for advanced knowledge. This advanced knowledge is not built on past study, however. At the same time as you find yourself in a greater field of love, you still walk on earth. You are not faced with an either-or choice. You have no choice. As you burst forth from your shell, you burst forth from old habits of restricted thinking. You are reborn, and you reconnoiter in the world anew. You keep one foot on earth. You fly in heaven while you also walk on earth. It is a balancing act, beloveds, to lead two lives, to carry on in the world while you transcend to heaven and join wholeheartedly with me. You are mooring deeply into oneness. Letting go of ego and letting go of the importance of ego is a great gift in your life. Strengthening of ego doesn't keep you in good stead. Lessening of ego keeps you in good stead because loss of ego is a great gaining. Being is being. You don't have to learn how to be. You are learning how to be while you are immersed in life on earth. You are learning how to get out of your way. You are learning to rise above the repeated past. You are learning to fly high and still be grounded on earth. With old baggage gone, you are light enough to soar. It takes no doing, simply being.